Hi everyone, my name is Sukaja. Welcome back to my booktube channel. As you know, the Halloween season is just around the corner, so I thought what better way to begin the season than by talking about a classic that everyone would love to revisit during this time. The book I have in mind is Rebecca by Daphne Du Maurier. It is a book that is loved by almost everyone I know in the literary world, and I'm sure if you haven't read it, it's a very good book that's definitely worth your time. Let me start this discussion by giving a bit of background info on the book. Rebecca is a story about myth at the heart of it. It begins with this governess who is a very plain and unassuming woman who doesn't have too much of a personality and is unfortunately rife with insecurity. She has so many insecurities and is very flawed as a person. She is sitting and having tea with her governess at a hotel in Monte Carlo when she has the pleasure of meeting this man who sweeps her off her feet. And next thing you know it, they're courting around, and then he asks her hand in marriage, and so begins her introduction, and she discovers what Rebecca is all about because she decides to get married to this man, Maxim de Winter, and they together go and live in the mansion that is Manderley, which is surrounded by red rhododendrons. And the description in the book is absolutely fantastic. It is lush with gothic elements and the book is very atmospheric. If you're somebody who loves historic fiction and loves an atmospheric read along the lines of the Essex Serpent or the Miniaturist, then you will love Rebecca. What I liked most about this book, and if you haven't read the book, I'll try and keep this as spoiler free as possible, but if you would like to be part of the discussion and like to know more, then stick around. From my reading, what I've gathered is that Rebecca is based loosely upon Daphne Du Maurier's own life, and she draws a lot of elements of inspiration from that. But this story has at the heart of it a juxtaposition. On the one hand, you have Rebecca, who is an absent presence throughout the book. She doesn't really exist as a character within the narrative, but she is somebody who is no more, and the narrator doesn't have a name. And that's another very interesting move, because Daphne Du Maurier, by not naming the narrator, is taking away power from her further. We are constantly being summoned into her mind. Rebecca exists larger than life in the narrator's mind itself. The more we hear about this narrator's perception of Rebecca, the more her insecurities are exaggerated. Now, this narrator feels the pressure to fill very large shoes when she becomes the mistress of Manderley. And she is constantly bombarded by the idea that she will never match up to the ones great flawlessness of being a hostess and hosting brilliant parties, all of those wonderful things that Rebecca was able to do when she lived back in the day. But the interesting thing about this book is that the narrator doesn't really know Rebecca personally, but she gets to have an idea of Rebecca, of the kind of person Rebecca might have been when she was alive, simply by talking to all the people in the narrative. And the first being Mrs. Danvers. Mrs. Danvers seems like a fangirl of Rebecca. Danvers is just the housekeeper, and she obviously has worked in close proximity with Rebecca. She has this feeling that she should be protective of Rebecca even after her death. In great sense, it seems that Mrs. Danvers has what is an obsession of Rebecca, and this obsession borders along unhealthy lines. It is my theory that perhaps Mrs. Danvers had feelings for Rebecca, and these feelings bordered somewhere between motherly feelings and that of a lover's. This is just my perception, but I would love to hear what you thought of the character of Mrs. Danvers and what kind of obsession she harbors for Rebecca and how that helps take the narrative forward. I would love to hear your thoughts in the comment section down below. This is a phenomenal piece of fiction, and I definitely think it is deserving of rereads. Another few things that I observed: this novel is based so much on storytelling, and we only know Rebecca from the stories of the servants and, you know, the people and Maxim de Winter himself, who barely ever mentions her because he's ridden with guilt. Now, the narrator doesn't really have much of a life. She doesn't have much of purpose, and she doesn't know what to do with herself, so she just goes with the flow. That's her attitude. Whereas Rebecca was the kind of person who was very sorted, or rather she came across to people around her as somebody who knew exactly what she wanted. She stands in juxtaposition to the narrator, and I love how Du Maurier works with this dichotomy. The person who wrote the foreword to my book had also talked about this. I found that very interesting, building characters with the help of contrast in a narrative. Me and my friend felt that this book was accessible and has been written in such a way that it appealed to a wide range of audiences. But yes, it is a woman-centric book. But while it is a woman-centric book, it does have certain male characters, and you can see the difference between a woman with no agency, who is the narrator, whereas Rebecca was somebody who was unconvincing unconventional, far ahead of her times. She didn't care what people thought. Then again, it brings to the question whether Rebecca really was like that, or is she the kind of woman we all aspire to be? Is she the kind of woman that the narrator aspires to be, and she projects all of her own desires, her hidden insecurities, onto this idea of Rebecca in her mind? And that is further given fertilization when people talk about Rebecca and her greatness. Definitely she was flawed, definitely she was unconventional, known to have had multiple affairs with multiple men. Definitely her character comes across as questionable. But at the same time, back in the day, to have written a work like this, I definitely think Du Maurier was far ahead of her time. Very daring to have written a narrative like this. Absolutely loved the gothic feel of this book. It is not as much a ghost story or a story of a haunting as it is the story about women and what it's like to be in the shoes of a woman, and the kind of pressure that society puts on her and the kind of expectation society has of women, at least back in the day, is made very clear through this narrative. This is all I have to say. I thought this video would be timely because we have the movie already out on Netflix, and I'm definitely going to be watching it with my friends today. Let me know what you thought of the film. Love to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. I will be back with more bookish videos. Please give me a thumbs up if you like this video and share it with your friends. Stay safe, stay sane, and I will see you very soon. Bye.